टुडेज डिस्कशन इज द एफिकेसी ऑफ टेनिलिग्लिप्टिन एज एन एड ऑन थेरेपी इन टाइप 2 डायबिटीज मेलाइटस पेशेंट्स रिप्रेजेंटेड विद इनएडिक्वेट ग्लाइसेमिक कंट्रोल विद मैक्सिमम टॉलरेबल डोज ऑफ मेटफॉर्मिन. आई एम डॉक्टर वेश कुमार जोशी, पीज रेजिडेंट फाइनल ईयर इन डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मेडिसिन इन तिथांका महावीर मेडिकल कॉलेज एंड रिसर्च सेंटर मुरादाबाद यूपी. इंट्रोडक्शन. The goals of treatment in type 2 DM is to achieve glycemic control and minimize the risks of macrovascular and microvascular complications. Incretin-based therapies, including DPP-4 inhibitors and glucagon-like peptide 1 receptor agonists, have been cornerstone of therapy for type 2 DM mellitus since the evolution of incretin. Indeed, consensus statements from American College of Endocrinology, American Association of Clinical Endocrinologists, and the Latin American Diabetes Association consider DPP-4 inhibitors ahead of sulfonylureas, mainly driven by their lower risk of hypoglycemia as well as weight neutrality. DPP-4 inhibitors are particularly popular in the treatment of type 2 DM as they are oral drugs, less costlier, with modest to moderate glucose lowering with novel mechanism of action and also have additional potential to protect from hypoglycemia through unique glucagon dynamics. Teneligliptin has been already approved and marketed since 2012. Teneligliptin works by inhibiting the activity of an enzyme known as DPP-4, an enzyme which is responsible for degrading incretins such as GLP-1, which helps to increase the release of insulin, which in turn leads to lower blood glucose levels. Aim and objectives of study are to evaluate the efficacy of teneligliptin as an add-on therapy in type 2 DM patients with inadequate glycemic control with a maximum tolerable dose of metformin, that is 1 to 2 gram per day. Objective is to assess the effect of teneligliptin over a period of 3 months in patients with poor glycemic control after using metformin on fasting blood sugar, postprandial blood sugar, HbA1c, lipid parameters. Material analysis. The present study was conducted among 130 type 2 diabetic patients in the Department of Medicine at Tithankar Mahavir Medical College and Research Center from December 2019 to August 2020. Inclusion criteria was patient who had poor glycemic control despite taking a maximum tolerable dose of metformin 1 to 2 gram for at least 1 month was selected for the study and having HbA1c between 7 and 9. Exclusion criteria was patient with type 1 diabetes mellitus who were on insulin or prescribed any other OHA after adding teneligliptin to metformin within 3 months. Patients in which the dose of metformin has to be altered due to like metformin-related gastropathy, hypersensitivity to the drug, or known case of pancreatitis, intestinal obstruction, CVAC hepaticolineal impairment. Ethical approval was obtained for the study from the ethics committee of the institute and written informed consent was taken from the patients. Procedure. Selected patients were prescribed with teneligliptin 20 mg tablet once daily in addition to already prescribed maximum dose of metformin. Patients' weight, fasting plasma glucose level, postprandial glucose level was regularly assessed during routine clinical visits. At the end of 3 months, HbA1c and lipid profile were assessed. Data was entered in Microsoft Excel 2010 and statistical analysis was done using IBM SPSS V24 version. Results was in total in 130 patients, we had 40 patients with less than 40 years 18. Less than 41 to 50, 32, 51 to 60, 47, more than 60 years, 33, in which male was 69 and female was 61. With 59 patients with family history, 71 without family history. Comorbidity seen was hypertension in 41, cardiovascular disease in 8 patients, hypothyroidism in 9, and no comorbidity in 72 patients. Results was before treatment mean HbA1c was 8.23 and after treatment mean HbA1c was 7.12. Fasting blood glucose before treatment was 162 and after treatment was 129. Postprandial blood glucose level before treatment was 284 and after treatment was 206. Triglyceride level before treatment was 155.62 and after treatment was 134.86. HDL before treatment was 38, after treatment was 42. LDL before treatment 115, after treatment 90.7. VLDL before treatment 39.36, after treatment 34.82. Adverse events observed was hypoglycemia, constipation, abdominal pain, acidity, tingling, tiredness, weakness, dry skin. The present work clearly demonstrated that pranolipin as add-on therapy with metformin significantly reduced plasma glucose, HbA1c, fasting, and postprandial concentration at regular clinical visit and at the end of 3 months as compared to their baseline values. It is reported that pranolipin in combination with glipizide significantly improved fasting blood glucose at 12 weeks compared to add-on placebo group, but there higher incidence of hypoglycemia. In the present study, the incidence of hypoglycemia symptoms was 4.39%. Hence, the incidence of hypoglycemia was there, suggesting that pranolipin did not increase the risk of hypoglycemia at 20 mg dose per day.
According to have to conclude, which is very already you have taken much time.
Okay, sir. Okay. Conclusion: add-on therapy with pranolipin was found superior in reducing plasma glucose concentration, fasting, and postprandial and HbA1c levels significantly in patients with type 2 DM. Further, it was found effective and well tolerated in Indian patients with type 2 DM who are inadequately controlled with conventional therapy. Overall, the present study will be a valuable addition to the accumulating data on pranolipin. Particularly, the Indian evidence has been lacking and is therefore welcome. However, several questions remain in the efficacy and particular safety of pranolipin as discussed. Thank you.